Would you like to run against me?
No.
Let me tell you, when I was younger, I won 3 races. Is still interested to challenge me? I have been a regular member of most women running competition in Iran for about 3 years. Lucky you are, I may not be interested in any competition anymore. Madam Toastmaster, fellow members, and very welcome guests. Let me tell you a story. The day when I had to run for about 4 kilometers to finish the coach training program, I badly injured my leg due to the many difficult training that we had during that week. That time, I didn't think about anything except getting my training license. Despite my family's intention not to let me go, I went and ran. That time, I didn't think about anything, and I never felt pain at all. But after that, when I finished my running, I couldn't walk and I couldn't move for a week. Staying at home for a week wasn't very convenient for me because I was working and studying at the same time. But when I heard that I had successfully finished the program and was now officially eligible to have the class by myself and train the student by myself, I became so excited. And my pain was getting better little by little after that. Besides running, my interests are very diverse. I can't find my real interest in painting. I was painting when I was in Iran. My first painting was created in Mother Nature when we, a group of students with our teacher, to the mountain. The weather was sunny and beautiful, and you know I like spring. It was a great experience to know how to mix the color and bring the real picture of the nature on the canvas. I started, but it didn't work at all. I tried a little bit. I look at my friends and very professional people in the group, how they were working very quickly, but it didn't work. I couldn't continue. I tried to catch my teacher, but he seemed very busy. Finally, I could find him for a while to ask him what I should do. He patiently mixed some color, put some line on some part of my painting, and my painting was totally changed. Unbelievable. My mom was always encouraging me to continue my painting classes. When I came back home and she looked at my painting, she became very excited. My father and my brother as well. But was it really a good painting? Look at this.
Wow. Not really.
Nice. But my painting progress after that was rather good. This is the painting that I created after that. And the other one is this. And this is that I gave to my sister. Madam Toastmaster, fellow members, and very welcome guests. I told you 2 real examples of my past life that clearly prove the fact that when I persisted in something, I did the best I could and I tried to be successful. When I arrived in Canada back in 2003, I had one major goal in my mind, to become successful in Canada. In 2009, I was working hard to finish my PhD. I was spending too many days and nights researching on my PhD thesis, hoping that one day I can be a good researcher in the field of econometrics in Canada. Right after, I got a permanent position in Ottawa for the government of Canada. Then I moved to Ottawa. And right now, I am a person who is working actively for the government of Ontario. But are they the only goals that I were dying for? Of course not. I had one major plan in my life. I want to be a person who can deliver her ideas clearly to the audience. To have had this dream come true, I joined Toastmaster Club. I joined Toastmaster Club in 2007 when I was a student in Montreal, and continued it when I moved to Ottawa in 2009. I can say without any hesitation that Toastmaster environments are always amazing, regardless of where they are located. People there are supporting and helping you to learn more and more about communication and leadership skills. Now this is the time for me to improve my communication and leadership skills. This is my resolution for this year. I've been a permanent member, an active member of your club, and hopefully a good and valued leader and speaker in the future, one of those persons.